ever wondered why some people seem to have a gift for music?
Have you ever wished that you could play by ear, sing in tune, improvise and jam?
You're in the right place. Time to turn those wishes into reality.
Welcome to the Musicality Podcast
with your host, Christopher Sutton.
In this episode, we're going to be talking about pentascales. We recently had Sarah Campbell join us on the show, and one thing she talked about was how pentascales had given her the opportunity to see the keyboard in a new way and start making a visual connection to how scales and chords are arranged on piano. I wanted to pick up on that and talk a bit about pentascales and what makes them interesting, and also how they're different from the pentatonic scale. First things first, what is a pentascale? You're probably familiar with the idea of a scale in music. It's a set of notes arranged in pitch order, ascending or descending. The most well-known kinds of scale are major scales and minor scales, but there are many more beyond those. Scales are closely related to the key of a piece of music, the set of notes that are used for its melody and harmony, and they can provide us with an insight into how music is constructed and how the melody and harmony relate to each other. A pentascale is a type of five-note scale. The name gives it away, with penta meaning five. It's actually just the first five notes of the regular major scale. So if we take C major as an example, the major scale runs C, D, E, F, G, A, B, and C again. The C major pentascale is simply C, D, E, F, and G. Let's hear those two together. Here's the major scale. And here's the pentascale. So what's interesting and useful about pentascales? Well, pentascales came up in conversation with Sarah because she is primarily a piano teacher, and they're a type of scale that's particularly popular with pianists. The major reason, as Sarah explained in that episode, is that humans have five fingers. If you want to play a full major scale on piano with one hand, you'll need to move the whole hand partway through the scale. This is a tricky skill to get the hang of for beginner pianists. A pentascale makes life easier, especially for kids, because you don't need to move the hand to play the whole scale. All the notes are within reach. Of course, playing scales as scales is not all that interesting or useful, but the same thing extends to everything that we use scales for, specifically for melodies and chords. When you first start out at the piano, it's easiest to learn pieces which don't require you to move your hands around. With your wrist staying still, a pentascale lets you assign one note to each finger and thumb and have the maximum variety of notes available without moving your hand around the keyboard. So there's a lot of beginner piano repertoire designed to be played without moving your hands, and it will often be built using the pentascale. Pentascales are not just for piano, though. Funnily enough, Sarah is also very familiar with the other group of musicians that know pentascales well, singers. She is a wonderful singer herself and also a vocal teacher, so she knows well where pentascales come into the picture for singers, and that's warm-ups. If you've ever heard a choir warming up, you've probably heard something like this. Dee 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 dee. They're just singing pentascales. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 5, 1. Do, re, mi, fa, so, fa, mi, re, do, so, do. Pentascales are nice for vocal warm-ups because they let you explore and warm up your range a bit more gradually than the full major scale. So pentascales are particularly familiar and useful to pianists and singers, but they're actually interesting for all musicians. Pentascales can be interesting for improvising, for example. The way we teach improvisation at Musical U is very ear-based, which gives you full creative flexibility, but can be a little overwhelming at first. So we also use the idea of constraints and playgrounds that limit the notes you're going to play, and that gives you a bit more confidence that what you improvise will sound good. Constraints can provide you with a safe zone for improvisation, and it can actually spark greater creativity too. By restricting yourself to the notes of the pentascale rather than the full major scale, you'll probably find you come up with new and different musical ideas than you would if you had the full major scale at your disposal. In fact, at Musical U, we actually pair it back to just three notes, do, re, and mi, for some exercises, and that really brings out your creativity in rhythm, dynamics, and the other dimensions of music aside from pitch. Pentascales are also interesting for their relationship to chords. The notes 1, 3, and 5 from the major scale give you a major triad chord, which is the most prevalent type of chord throughout music. And of course, those notes are in the pentascale too. They're just the top, middle, and bottom notes. You can also create a minor pentascale with the first 5 notes of the minor scale, and taking the first, third, and fifth notes from that gives you a minor triad chord, which is the next most common chord type. So pentascales encompass those chord notes, and that means they give you a nice compact framework for thinking about melodies and chords and how they relate to each other. If we come back to the example of a beginner piano player, once they've settled their hand with a finger per note of the pentascale, it's pretty easy for them to understand that if they just play their thumb, index finger, and pinky together, they're going to be playing a major chord. Magic! Of course, that same relationship holds true for other instruments too, and that can provide an easy insight into how chords fit in with the scale and the melody. Now, you might have been listening so far and wondering about another common type of scale with a similar name, the pentatonic. Pentascales are not the same as pentatonic scales. They are both 5-note scales, hence the similar name, but there is a small and important difference. As we've talked about, pentascales take the first 5 notes of the major scale. Pentatonic scales actually take a different 5 notes. They skip the 4th and they add in the 6th. So where a pentascale is do, re, mi, fa, so, a pentatonic scale is do, re, mi, so, la. Do, re, mi, fa, so, fa, mi, re, do. Do, re, mi, so, la, so, mi, re, do. Or in numbers, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 versus 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. The pentatonic scale is amazing, and we'll definitely be devoting an episode to it in future. But for now, just remember that a pentascale and a pentatonic scale are not the same thing, and everything we've talked about today was about pentascales specifically. So I hope that gives you a clear sense of what a pentascale is, why it's important for pianists and singers, and also how the implications for improvisation and the connection to chords make them quite interesting for all types of musician. Oh, and if you are a piano player or a vocalist, remember that Sarah Campbell is kindly providing her pentascale reference sheet free to our podcast listeners. Just head over to the show notes page for this episode or for her interview to find the link.
Thank you for listening to the Musicality Podcast. This episode has ended, but your musical journey continues. Head over to musicalitypodcast.com, where you will find the links and resources mentioned in this episode, as well as bonus content exclusive for podcast listeners. That's musicalitypodcast.com.